Welcome everyone to my channel that is Fast and Easy Maths, which is dedicated to give you tips and tricks related to mathematics. So students, today I'm going to solve few questions which involve fractions and multiplication with a number or a decimal number and all of that, okay? And trust me, here the trick is really very very simple and lot of y'all keep missing out on something which is very very simple. So you're just pay attention to few sums and you will know how quickly you can solve these kind of sums very quickly. Whenever you have off in multiplication, if you come across off, that means in mathematics, if you come across the word off, that means you just have to simply multiply. Okay, so now you have 3 upon 5 and of 20. Okay, so basically you're taking the fraction 3/5 of 20. If you want to find, then you just have to simply do 3 upon 5 into 20. Now what I was trying to tell y'all was that a lot of y'all keep multiplying first and then you end up dividing. Okay, but so basically what you all do is 3 into 20 is 60 upon 5 and then your answer becomes 12. Okay, now what I say is that whenever you have something like this and you have a denominator, then first always check that if something can get cancelled. So here I know 5 ones are and 5 fours are and 3 into 4 is 12, right? So this way your answer comes quickly and you might end up not making as many mistakes when doing this particular method. You directly multiply and then divide. So imagine if the multiplication was very big, then you might end up making a lot of mistakes. Okay, so over here also we have 6 upon 24 in of 80. So we know 6 ones are and 6 fours are is, sorry 6 6 fours are is going to get you 24 and 4 ones are and 4 20s are going to get you 80. So your answer is 20. Okay, next one, 72 108 of 5. So now I know 5 is a prime number which goes in neither of these two tables. But here, if you look closely, I can see that 72 and 108, both of them are even numbers. So for those of you who do not know much or who are not very confident, you can start by striking out with two's table. And if you go one step further, both of them can go in what? 3's table as well. So here we are now seeing that the numbers, both of these numbers are now being divisible in 3 as well as 2. So I can very confidently say that both of these two numbers are going in 6's table. So I can directly strike out by using the 6's table. So this is 6 12s are and here I'm getting 1 and 4, so 6 8s are. And 12 and 18, both of them goes in 3's table. So here I will have 3 6s are, or rather both of them go in 6 table again. So then 2s are and 3s are. Okay, so now I have 10 upon 3. Why 10? 2 into 5 is going to get you 10 upon 3. And this is an improper fraction. So you will have to convert it into mixed form. Please, this is very very important. We do not accept improper fractions as your final answer. Okay, now if you look closely over here, 39 itself is not going in this table, or actually it is going. We can do this, like this goes in 3's table, this goes in 3's table. But if you look closely, 61 is a prime number. Okay, and if you multiply that by 3, you will directly get 183. So 1's are, 3's are, 3 1's are and 13's are, your answer is 13. Okay, I know you might be wondering, because I'm a teacher and I can do this. No, that's not the case. Whenever you come across something like that, you just take a moment of pause and see if what maximum can get cancelled. Okay, your entire job reduces magnificently if you can cancel maximum numbers. Okay, and if you can reduce them. So now over here, now see, coming over here, now all of these have those fractions which cannot get cancelled. So in that case, what you do, okay? Students, if you're liking the way I'm explaining, then please go ahead and hit the like button, because that gives me tremendous amount of encouragement and in doing these kind of videos. Also, don't forget, at the end of this video, I'm putting a DIY question. You will let me know your answers in the comment section and I'll let you know whether you're right or wrong, okay? So now 7 upon 5 of 6. So now over here, we know all three are what? Not going in each other's table. So here I can directly do 42 upon 5. And this is again an improper fraction. So we'll have 8 2 by 5. This is your answer. okay. See, understand, for those who find doing this particular thing and you know converting an improper into a mixed form, it's very very simple. You just have to do what? Put 42 and 5. Whatever you get as your quotient becomes your first number, your remainder becomes what? Your numerator, and your divisor remains as your denominator. Okay, the next one, now we'll have 540 upon 11. So I know that 11 into what will get me 540, or something which is very close to 540. So I know that 11 into 4 is going to get you 44. So 44 taken from 54, I'm getting I'm left with 10. So then I know 11 nines are is 99. So then what is left? When you take 99 away from 100, I'm just left with 1. And that is my answer. Okay. Now coming over here. See, when you have something like this, this is quite tricky. I'm not saying that this is like super easy. Okay. So what you do over here is, we first do not, like I would rather suggest that always convert all these decimals into, you know, fractions, because then there are things which can get cancelled. Okay. So we have 400 upon 651 into 21 upon 100, right? So these are getting cancelled. Now I know that both of them are going in three tables. So this is 7s and this is 2s, 1s, and then again 7s. Now if you look closely, this also gets cancelled by 7. So I am left with 3 and 1. So my final answer is 4 upon 31. So you saw how easy this entire thing became? Yep. Okay. So now time for your do it yourself. Students, if you're liking the way I'm explaining, then please go ahead and hit the like button, and also share these videos with a lot of your friends, because trust me, these kind of basic tricks are something which a lot of people are not able to understand, and that is why they find mathematics very very difficult. My goal with this channel is to educate as many possible and to remove your fear for mathematics. Okay, trust me, it's one of the most brilliant subjects available on this planet. Okay, so now time for your do it yourself. Let me think. I will give you something a little bit tricky. So let's say 54 upon 81 into, or rather of, let's say 99. Do let me know your answers in the comment section, and don't forget, so now we are uploading 5 times a week. Okay, so stay tuned to my channel. Okay, bye, see ya, take care.